University study shows remarkable discoveries regarding depression and antidepressants. i24News reporter Danielle Ziri has more.
The most commonly used antidepressants may not be the most efficient. A study conducted at Tel Aviv University revealed that, unlike what was assumed so far, depression is not caused by a lack of serotonin, a type of hormone, but by damaged synapses, which are responsible for dispatching information within the brain.
We wanted to look at major depressive disorder because treating major depressive disorder is extremely challenging. A patient has to take a series of drugs, usually at different concentrations, till they find the exact drug and concentration that fits well to that particular patient. It's a very long trial and error, and it's extremely devastating for the patient, the family, and the physician.
The research looked at the reactions of 80 cell samples to classic drugs such as Prozac. The result? The cures work for some, but not for others. According to the researchers, this gap is due to a gene named CHL1, a discovery which has numerous implications on the treatment of major depressive disorders.
We know that the effectiveness of antidepressant drugs are between 50 and 60%. In order to get a really personal and understanding and fitting into a particular patient, we need further experiments, and this is what we're doing now.
Depression remains a phenomenon that affects a significant part of the population at different levels. In most developed countries, including Israel, over 10% of the population suffers from the disorder.
I would say it's common, especially in the Western world, where we live extremely hectic lives, extremely busy lives, and all this pressure around us probably drives us to these different clinical manifestations. And obviously there's different levels of depression. It could be chronic, long-term, it could be short-term.
In order to better generalize their findings, the Israeli researchers have now begun conducting experiments on mice. These experiments, they hope, will lead to radical changes in the prescribed solutions for patients all over the world.